Engineer Eric here. We are here to say that this month, October, is Michael's birthday. October 18th. He would have been 40 this year. So what are we going to do, Eric, to celebrate Daddy's birthday? Daddy. First, we're going to, throughout the day, we're going to eat the foods that he loved most. So we're going to have some bacon for breakfast and eggs because Daddy loves eggs. Eggs and bacon. Daddy. Then for lunch, we'll have some sushi because he loves sushi. And then for dinner, we're going to go have a burger because he loved burgers. And we're going to visit his grave. Don't know if the headstone will be there yet or not. It was ordered a while ago. But yeah, we're going to celebrate Daddy.
Daddy.
Can you say Daddy?
Daddy.
Some people say they're coincidences. And I guess it's no coincidence that we got number 39 here at Guru's. Michael, you will always be 39. Today would have been your 40th birthday. We're here having some bacon and eggs and a pancake and coffee. Michael loves coffee. I forgot my microphone. This Guru's has a little free library with poetry here. And we found a little book of love poems. I had a mini breakdown at Guru's at breakfast. They just kept playing these bittersweet songs, and emotions started to overcome me as I was thinking about the coincidence or synchronicity of having order number 39. And it's going to be one of those days. I thought it would be a happy day, but there's still a lot of emotions. Yeah. And Michael shouldn't be gone on his birthday. He should be celebrating it with us. Sushi. Eric's asleep in the back, but I got sushi to go. This is for you, Michael, your favorite. I'm wearing one of his favorite dresses of mine and his ring. My ring. Got some flowers. This is the spot right here. Looks like the gravestone is not ready yet. Took me a while to find the spot, but he's next to our grandpa and one of our cousins. So I think rather than laying these flowers down just on the middle of the grass where it might get mowed over, I'm gonna lay them between my grandpa and my cousin. We'll say, we miss you, Michael. And we think about you every day. And love you. And now we're gonna go visit your mom and bring her some flowers too. While I'm still at the cemetery, I thought I'd add some more thoughts about Michael. Michael, you taught me patience, unconditional love, courage, honesty, and compassion. And I will never forget my time with you. I think that death puts an exclamation point on life. The things that you lived for, the things that were important to you, kind of get an extra like emphasis by your death. And sometimes tragedy is a part of life. I think of the tragedy of Romeo and Juliet and how, you know, their love was so passionate but so brief, and our love was marked by themes of separation, loss. I mean, we spent most of our lives apart. We only got 2.5 years, then that's rounding up. We got about 2.5 years together and a few sparse memories as kids. So I think that when we are reunited, it will be very joyful and very much anticipated. It's raining pretty hard, so we decided to DoorDash our dinner. It's Burger Supreme, cheeseburger, large fries, and a cherry coke. So we are just gonna be home.
Hi.
And be comfortable. I'm in jammies. And we are just going to take it easy the rest of Michael's birthday. Okay, Eric, you ready to sing?
Yeah.
Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Michael, Daddy. Happy birthday to you. Okay, you want to help me blow it out? Don't touch, it's hot. Go. Hot. Yay! Now we get to eat it.